Well, good morning, everyone. I want to start by thanking my colleagues standing behind me right now for being true leaders, not on the issues surrounding just issues that impact women, but across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. You know, the House Democratic women, my colleagues and friends that I serve with, are not leaders in our caucus. That would be inappropriate to just say that they are simply leaders in our caucus. They are the leaders pushing a progressive policy agenda forward throughout the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And they deserve a tremendous amount of our thanks and our gratitude because they are improving the lives of people in every legislative district, regardless of if the person who serves that district is a Democrat or a Republican, conservative, or a progressive. And so I want to thank them on behalf of many of the folks that I represent. You know, my legislative district is one of the poorest ones in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, certainly between Philadelphia and Harrisburg. And one of the things that is a travesty, and Representative Schlossberg can speak to this as well, is the age of our schools. We have a school, a middle school in my district, where Representative Schlossberg's wife serves as an English teacher. That was built and completed in 1871. We like to joke that the new wing of the school was completed in 1891. We have over 1,000 students, the overwhelming majority of whom are Latino and African American students that attend the school that was first completed when Ulysses S. Grant was president of the United States. Now, we could talk about Ulysses S. Grant's support for the Transcontinental Railroad or the creation of the Department of Justice, and perhaps we can even say that the taxpayers got the money's worth out of a school that was completed way back when. But we have electricity now. We also have the internet, at least in some parts of our Commonwealth. But in that school, those 1,000-plus students, the teachers, overwhelming majority of those teachers are, in fact, women, are working in unsafe and substandard conditions. And the irony of that school, even though it's the next one to be demolished and hopefully be rebuilt in that neighborhood, is that it's actually not the most toxic school in our district because it was built before asbestos. It was built before lead paint was the only thing that was available to folks. Now, it's still extraordinarily dangerous because, you know, again, it was built pre-electricity and we have wires hanging all over the place, and it's quite the sight. I would also mention, having just come from Legislative Black Caucus's hearing on voting rights, it's also a polling place in the poorest precinct in Allentown. Just want to point that out. But what we're facing across Pennsylvania are a million Harrison Whartons. In school districts like Allentown and Philadelphia, and school districts in Pittsburgh, school districts in York, school districts in Harrisburg, school districts in the most rural parts of Pennsylvania. We have schools that were built when the only way to insulate and fireproof a school is by spraying a carcinogen across the entire school, where we see if there's a leaky pipe, that leaky pipe was probably a lead pipe, and every time your kid goes to take a drink of water at a water fountain, you have no idea what's actually going into those into their young bodies. That's what we're facing. Pennsylvania House Democrats have produced a plan that would begin to reverse this trend. It was only a few years ago, as my colleagues on the Appropriations Committee can attest to, where we zeroed out the line item for what's known as PlanCon, which is the state's investment in the physical infrastructure of education in Pennsylvania. That was a mistake then, and it's one of those things that we can begin to reverse those trends. In the plan that our leadership has put together, we are talking specifically about investing $250 million into toxic schools, into new school construction. Now, is that enough? The answer is no. But I know what it's more than. It's more than the zero that we ultimately will do if we don't start the process now. And hopefully there'll be the next generation of students coming behind, next generation of students coming up won't have to worry about, and their parents won't have to worry about what's in their drinking waters, what they're breathing in the air. Is there lead paint throughout it all? Is there access to internet? Is there access to electricity? Because I tell you right now, in Allentown and places across Pennsylvania, parents are legitimately worried about that.